Under my rock. No, 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 no. Oh, I'm practicing my vocal warm-ups, so I'm ready for my part in the show. Under my rock. Oh, you're the Moe Twins. I heard about you guys from Oscar.
Yeah, we need your help with a great trick. I'm Tricky Tricky Trick. A tricky 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 trick.
A trick? I like tricks. What is the trick?
Well, you see, we want to go before Masson. Yeah, but we gotta get Mr. Kermit out of the way first.
You know what I mean?
No, not that. We mean keep him distracted.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah, so we help us trick him. Yeah, so we can go on stage.
Under one condition.
What?
You let me give you a big Patrick Star introduction.
Deal.
Okay, now you two hide. I'll get Kermit away. Got a shot card. Oh, I know. Oh, Kermit.
What do you want?
You gotta go outside right now.
Why do I need to go outside?
Because Spot got stuck in a tree.
Dominic's dog?
Yeah. It got stuck in a tree.
Okay, I'm going to take care of it right now. Oh, God.
Okay, he's gone. Come on, you two. Hurry. God's sake. I'll just you. Hurry. Oh, boy. And now it's time for a Patrick Star introduction for this next actor. Robin, why are you still on stage?
I don't know. I was just heading that way. Never mind.
Okay. Now it's time for Patrick Star introduction. Here now are two characters that Mike's Two in Town grew up with. The singer's song what's the song about? Okay. Peanut Butter. Here to sing their Peanut Butter song are Bog and Quagmire, the Moe Twins. Yay.
Jam and spreads on ham and cheese and coconuts. From east to west with foods the best. No ifs or ands or buts. What is the base that has the taste to set your heart to flutter? Peanut butter! It tastes quite nice with beans and rice, spaghetti sauce as well. Be straight on some Brussels sprouts, I'm sure hooray you'll yell. And since bread all by itself is like a ship without the rudder, peanut butter! Yes, peanut butter is great, it's never out of place. So spread it on some bread or smear some on your face. Yes, peanut butter is the sticky stuff we use. The spread on steak or scampi cake or just to shine our shoes. Favorite to consume. It's really great. It's also neat to wear it as perfume. So if you chew your favorite stew and find it tasting bland, don't order out for pizza. You've just got to understand that if you had some, you know what you'll find on this other. Peanut butter!
Hey, that wasn't that bad, what'd you think?
Yeah, it kind of stuck to me.
Oh man, you two were phenomenal.
Yeah, that was a good trick we did to get on stage. Chicken cook.
Oh, hi, Patrick. That was not Dominic's dog stuck in the tree. It was a raccoon. I hate raccoons. Ugh. I'm going to let you off with a warning because I heard the Moe Twins sing their song. And I think you guys pleased Mike's Two in Town, but please don't do that again.
No promises!
Where'd they go? I don't know.
Yeah, well, I'm going to go get ready for my part in the show. Oh, Darby Rock!
Oh, brother. Oh, speaking of parts in the show, I can introduce the next act.
Okay, folks, so apparently Meowth has something planned for us. I don't really know what it is, but I hope it's good. Ladies and gentlemen, Meowth. Thank you. Reba, you. Hello, ladies and germs. Tonight, I, the great Meowth, present to you an amazing act. A sacrifice act. A what? And for my sacrifice act, I will be sacrificing this demon. Where did you find her at? Apparently backstage. She was trying to turn Foz into a bear rug after his comedy spot. But they thought she ate. Thought she died in the SpongeBob show. How the hell is this happening? I don't know. Just get somewhere with it. I don't want to look at her face. Okay. Now, for this sacrifice, I'll be using these scissors. And I will be turning with the plant. All right, Planty. Don't eat her till I say so. All right. Any last words before you sacrifice, demon?
Screw you, you little furball of a dork.
Oh, that's it. Now I'm going to enjoy this. I hereby sacrifice to the depths of hell. Die, die. Die, I say. I hope I'm cleansing your souls, all you my student town people. Oh, no, you don't. Holy crap. I never knew me of that this side of him.
Yeah, I'm completely surprised. It's not like he's a dark type Pokemon.
You thought you could escape me? I'll show you. Gotcha.
Rip off your head. You know what? Screw this.
Kermit, should we stop this? On the one hand, Meowth acted like a turtle nut job, but on the other hand, it's Reggie Rocket, so I really don't care. What to do? Yuppie nuts. Hey, Roderick, Tarzan, get that cat off stage!
Alright, Planty, eat her. With pleasure.
Excuse me.
Yes, blood, bloody blood, tons of blood, and death, lots of death, and no, wait, I'm just getting started, I can kill his brothers, wait a minute, stop!
Well, it's official, the show's gone into chaos. Don't say that. Well, can you blame me? I mean, look what just happened. Yeah, but don't worry, the show will be saved, because thankfully we got a nice, quiet, peaceful number coming right up. It'll be fine.
Honey.
Everything is honey, everywhere I see. Everything is honey, and that's quite alright with me. I'm a bird of little brain, I can't explain why everything will be changing into the favorite snack of Winnie the Pooh. Can you?
No.
Everything is honey, I can't get enough. I pop lots and lots and pots of licky sticky stuff. Oh what a sight, oh what a dream, dust of wonderful honey for stream. Swimming in the honey, swimming far and wide. Open up my mouth and let the honey flow inside. Gooey and gooey and very sweet, eat, eat and repeat. Suddenly I'm in a honey boat, doesn't matter where I float. Whoa! Cause everywhere is honey, There's a honey poo. He's a human of honey, so I guess I'll eat him too. If everything is honey, and I am what I eat, I must be made of honey. And life is very sweet.
What a sweet number.
Yeah, but Bigfoot kind of started on the lyrics a bit.
Yeah, well, that tends to happen. Yeah, but it kind of made the performance kind of sticky. Wait.
Mr. Horton, did you have to do a trumpet at the end of that song?
Well, there was a weird trumpet solo at the end of that song, so it felt necessary.
He's got a point there, Bird.
I guess you're right, Snuffy.
Was finding the way. Yeah, I know.
Mr. Kermit, I finally have an act I can do in the show.
Really?
Yes, and guess what? What? It's all about food.
Oh, food. Yeah, that's perfect. Because Bart likes food, Girl likes food, Homer likes food, and Shrek likes food. It's perfect. Oh, good. Are you ready to go on telly?
Not yet. I need a few minutes and I'll be ready.
Okay, good luck.
I am generally curious to see what his act is.
Yeah, me too.
Ladies and gentlemen, and everybody else, I, President Mr. Peanuts, would now like to read to you from the Declaration of Independence.
Psst, Mr. Peanuts, that's not the right document. You're not reading the Declaration of Independence.
I'm not?
No.
Oh, thank goodness. I was starting to wonder why they wanted me to read that, because it's kind of boring. It doesn't fit, like, the good theme of this show.
No. Here's the document you'll be reading. It is, Nickelodeon's Declaration of Kids' Rights.
That's a thing.
Yeah, from 1990, which is how old this document is. It's from the 1990s.
Oh. Well, I guess I could do that.
Yeah, good. Well, here's the document. Oh, thank you very much.
Your services are greatly appreciated.
I've just been told that by the actual president.
Fans.
And now, I, President Peanuts, and I'll read for the Nickelodeon's Declaration of Kids' Rights from June 7th of 1990. In the course of history, it has become perfectly clear that all people are born with certain ineligible rights.
You can't read well, folks. Sorry.
Among them, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. But these rights haven't always applied to kids.
Wow. Just does wow.
And it stinks. Now, 200 years after the creation of America's Bill of Rights, this declaration proclaims that the world... that you have rights too.
Excuse us for the pauses, folks.
you have the right to be seen, heard, and respected as a citizen of the world.
Look at me. Look at me. And listen to me. Yeah, I have rights to be respected too. You know, I'm sorry, Mr. President.
Anyway, okay. You have the right to a world that's peaceful and an environment that's not spoiled.
Yeah, you could tell this is written years before our time now.
Anyway, back to the document. You have the right to be treated with equality, religion, regardless of race, religion, nationality.
Hold the phone. Roger, get back here.
Can I say this?
What? Let me see. I can't read it.
It's upside down. Oh, sorry. Where? Look after, religion. Religion, nationality.
Oh, wait. No. You don't understand. I think they mean gender in this case. Oh, thank goodness. Yeah.
It's from Nickelodeon. What do you expect? I am sorry, okay? Anyway. Personality, grades, and size. You have the right to make mistakes without someone making you feel like a jerkhead.
You can tell this is written for kids, folks.
You have the right to be protected from harm, injustice, and hatred. You have the right to an education that prepares you to run the world when it's your turn. You have the right to your opinion and feelings, even if others don't agree with them. So there. And there you have it. The Nickelodeon Declaration of Kids' Rights on June 7th, 1990. Wait, Mr. Peanut, sir? Well, Roderick. How are you going to end this? Because this doesn't seem very much of an exciting sketch. Hey, I'm the president, so I declare how the sketch ends. And I say... Slime Party! Slime Party? Yeah, when I did a Nickelodeon thing. Hit it! Hey, a slime party, wait for me! Why not? If the president's doing it. Peace out, my Americans! Happy birthday, Mike's Toontown! Hey, the president's doing it, wait.
So why not us? Please!
That was good, Mr. Peanuts. I mean, Mr. President. But who's going to clean up the slime? Oh, don't worry. I got cleaners already on it. They'll be done in a minute. Oh, good.
Mr. Kermit, I'm ready to go on.
Good, Telly, but wait a minute, because they're cleaning up the slime from the stage.
Slime?
Yeah, the president called for a slime party.
Oh, that sounds like fun.
Yeah, so you got to clean up after.
Oh, good point.
Okay, my man got the slime cleaned up. Okay, Telly, get your acting on stage.
Oh, yes, sir.
Okay. I am generally curious to see what his act is. Aren't you?
If you haven't noticed, Telly's been trying to get an act together, and he's finally ready. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Telly Monster.
Thank you. Thank you. And now I present my singing food. Okay, guys, like in rehearsal. 1, 2, 3.
Yes, we have no bananas. We have no bananas today, bananas today.
We've mushrooms and cupcakes and steamed fish and tacos
and all other foods like that. We have an old-fashioned tomato, a nice, juicy potato. But yes, we have no bananas. We have no bananas today.
Oh, I love my singing food. How are you, Taco?
My excellent day.
How's the cupcake?
Sweet as always.
Oh, what's wrong, Mr. Corn?
Oh, my ears hurt.
How's it going over there, fish?
Simply swimmingly. And yes, we have no bananas.
We have no bananas. We said no bananas. We have no bananas today.
Thank you! We did it! Yay!
Telly, that was amazing! Yeah, that was great.
Oh, thank you so much. I hope those Mike Toontown people liked it.
I'm sure they will.
Yeah, well, I gotta go.
Where are you going?
Oh, I gotta find Cookie Monster. Make sure he doesn't eat my group.
Oh, good thinking, Telly. Well, now we can relax because the rest of the show is gonna go great. I don't know. Why? Don't you remember who's next? I'm next to... Oh, no! Patrick's on next! Oh, no! Oh, I already know the kind of act he'll do. What are we gonna do? Pray. That's the only thing we can do. It's pray.
And now it's time for the Facts of Life! With me, Patrick Starr! Ah! Hello, everybody! It's time through the two facts of life with me, Patrick Starr. But first, Kermit, if you're watching this, give the world according to Patrick Starr reboot effective immediately, please. Anyway, I'm here to tell you about the two things of life in the world today. Like, first, let's talk about Mario. Or should I say Garfield? That's right. I don't care if the movie's been out for a long time. Mario is Garfield. No, Garfield is Mario. It's a fact. It's a true fact. There's proof and there's a fact. It is a fact. But let's talk about Squidward. He sucks at everything. He sucks at music and art and life and everything. And he's got a big nose. And his favorite game is Squidward Loses the Game. It's what we call Let's Carry Pants. And he always loses and it's always funny. Oh, and let's talk about the elephant in the room. Or should I say giraffe in the room? That's right, folks. Mr. Peanut's elephant is a giraffe. Yes, that's right. It is true. And not right now. Excuse me, I'm in the middle of it. Hi.
Now it's time for a new segment called Make Patrick Die. Let's get him. Wait a minute, wasn't Mario following us? Where'd he go?
Oh, you met Garfield. Who's that?
Shut up, be your fist, your tummy, dumbass.
I gotta practice my clarinet. I gotta go prove some documents.